In this video, I'm going to show you the process for getting signed up on the CodeWars.com site so that you can work on the homeworks. And I'm just going to go ahead and click on this sign up link. And I come to the main CodeWars page. And if you haven't registered before, you have to pass a test in order to sign up. So if I click on sign up here, it just basically says I must first prove my skill. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this Python box. And this is showing me a program that doesn't execute properly. And this may be a little too advanced for you if you're just starting out in the course. So I'm just going to show you what the answers are. And then I guarantee by the end of the course they will make sense to you. So this one, the problem is that you need to return these values. And we'll cover that when we get to functions. And then the next one, we're going to get towards the end of the class. So we need to correct the code so that the greet function returns the expected value. And I see that we're missing self.name here. And we're going to get that towards the end of the class. So now I've passed the two tests, and I can go ahead and register for the site. So for clan, go ahead and put Portland Community College. And for your email address, you can put whatever your email address is. I've already created an account for myself, so I'm just going to do a test. And we'll try test and enlist. Now, the CodeWars site generally works pretty well, but it's occasionally sluggish, and there are sometimes some problems actually submitting solutions. But if you come back later, they're usually okay. So for now, we're just going to use Python as a training language. All of these are supported pretty well. The rest of them, not yet. We'll go ahead and save. And here's the current listing of everybody that's joined the Portland Community College clan. This is my account, CIS122. So you can either follow me or just go ahead and jump into the challenges. So now that I'm logged into the site, I'm going to go back to the CodeWars homepage and let's work through the first one of these, simple printing. So here's a description of the kata. And it's basically explaining some differences between the print statement in PyCharm, which is in Python version 3, and the print statement that they use in CodeWars, which is based on Python version 2.7. So that was one of the big changes when they went to version 3, is the print statement changed. And since CodeWars is using the old version of Python, there are some differences. And the big one is on CodeWars, you'll use XPrint if you want to print a value instead of just using the regular print statement. So I'm going to go ahead and train. And the first thing we need to do is write some Python 2.7 print statements, which are a little different from Python 3.0 print statements. The big difference is that in 2.7, there are no parentheses here. In 3.0, there are parentheses. So the first one's a give me. It just prints hello world, which is display hello world. And I'm going to go ahead and run these tests. So I have a bunch of starter test cases. And this is going to check all of my code here to make sure it's correct. So I hit run tests. And I passed the first one because it's printing hello world correctly. But I didn't pass the second one because I haven't written that yet. So let's go ahead and write that. So here's the second challenge. Course is CIS122. Name is, I'm just going to copy and paste. So copy and paste. And then we want to print this. So let's just go ahead and paste it in and hit the run button and see what we get. So it didn't quite pass, And if you look really carefully, you'll see there's a space here, but no space there. So this is what it's expecting, and this is what I actually produced. So it's almost the same, but the spacing is a little off. So if I want to get rid of this space here, it's automatically inserted. What I'm going to do, it's actually this space right here. It automatically puts a space between course and this colon. So what I'm going to do instead is add these two things together to make one big string. And when you add strings together, they just get jammed together. And then these other spaces are fine. So let's go ahead and try it now. Great, so I passed the second test, and now I'm up to the third one. So I'm going to scroll down to this one. And let's go ahead and set A to 1.1, B to 3. And then we'll set C equal to A plus B. And then we want to print this stuff here. So I'm going to go ahead and paste that in. And let's try running it and see how we do. So I've passed the first three tests, which is all the Python 2 tests. Now I have to finish the Python 3 tests. So I passed the first one, and then I'm stuck on the second. So the one that I passed is another gimme. It's just saying hello world. And it's using XPrint. So XPrint behaves exactly like the regular print does, except it's Python 3. So let's go ahead and set language equal Python and adjective is fun. And then let's display this sentence. And let's try running it, see if it works. So we passed the second test, and we have one more. So here's the last one. Pizzas is 10. Slices per pizza is 8. Total slices equal pizzas times slices per pizza. And then we're going to print this. Got an extra double quote there. And then we're also going to print this. And we'll see how we're doing. Now, I can already tell that we have a colon here that's probably going to need to be right up against here. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the separator for print to be nothing. So if I try it now, I've passed all of the tests in the example test set. So now that I'm ready, I think I have everything right, I can go ahead and click Submit. And this will run my code against the full test set. And I pass the full test set as well. It says, good job, you may take your time to refactor, comment your solution, and submit when ready. And then when you're ready, you can click Submit Final. And when you do that, you've completed the kata, and you'll get some honor points. So that's CodeWars.org, and I hope you enjoy the kata I've prepared for you.